Richard Southern joins us to chat about some of the day's more interesting stories. And we begin with a show that many of us grew up watching. It's now making a comeback of sorts, Richard.
My Little Pony, were you a fan growing up?
I can't say it was one of the shows that I watched growing up, unfortunately, but I know my little niece, she loves it.
Right, mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, it was a good lesson, I think, the show in like product placement, in that it was based, I believe, on the Hasbro toys.
Yeah.
They had the toys first, and then they decided
maybe
to do a big series in the 80s and 90s. But My Little Pony getting a reboot now, Erica. It's back with a new Netflix show.
What?
This version, though, a lot more adult. A review from the New York Times says that some of the My Little Ponies in this new series are anti-magic, aka anti-science, and are prone to fear-mongering, except for the enlightened hero pony of the show, who crashes a demonstration led by essentially a defensive weapons manufacturer who profits from a community afraid of being attacked by other pony-like creatures. I don't know if we're ready, Erica, for these growing-up My Little Ponies, huh?
It's quite the complex storyline for My Little Pony, but maybe they're assuming that their audience can get these kinds of messages, these stories, and understand them?
Yeah, I guess if you grew up with it, you're an adult now, you're ready for some adult content. I actually pitched a My Little Pony version to Netflix, which was swiftly rejected. It's the City News version. I thought it would be a hit, the City News version of My Little Ponies. Netflix said, you're crazy.
What? Richard. That looks like a dynamic team right there.
Yeah, Lindsay Dunn has a magic pony powers in that version.
I love it. Okay.
Maybe next season.
We'll make it happen, please.
Yeah.
What happens when you teach a robot how to dance? Well, you get a pretty entertaining halftime show.
Yeah, got more rhythm than I do. Spot, the Boston Dynamics robot. Look at this guy go. I love this guy.
Look at those moves.
He's got these moves. This was a U.S. college football halftime show on Saturday. And Spot was out there. This is Boston
shaking.
Dynamics robot. Shaking
what he's got. Yeah, or she.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or she. This is a robot now that's used by many companies and factories, used by police forces, but is also known for dancing. Not only this, but it actually started a couple of weeks ago in a BTS video. The Korean boy band was seen dancing with Spot, the robot. So I don't know about this, Erica, but certainly doing a better job than I would do.
Honestly, when they teach the robots to dance, I guess it's supposed to make you feel a little bit better about them, but it makes me anxious. I won't lie.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. No.
And it's official. Captain Kirk is heading into outer space.
Yeah, and he's wasting no time beaming up. We were talking about this story last week. It was an unconfirmed report. Now we got it confirmed.
Keep that in mind, Mr.
William Shatner is going to space, and he's doing it a week tomorrow. Jeff Bezos' space company, Blue Origin, confirming today that Shatner will be blasting off from Texas on October 12th. At age 90, he'll become the oldest person to ever go into space. Shatner releasing a written statement reading, quote, "I've heard about space for a long time. I'm taking the opportunity to see it for myself." What a miracle, Shatner says. Now, this Star Trek actor, he's not going to be the first to sort of leave the planet. Last year, it was revealed that the ashes of James Doohan, who played Scotty on the original series, were smuggled aboard the International Space Station in 2008, 3 years after his death. But of course, Shatner's going up there, living and breathing, and that's going to be quite something to see
next
week.
That is so incredible. Imagining starring decades ago in a series about outer space and then getting to actually go to outer space later on in life.
He probably would have never have thought.
I know.
A good Canadian native, too, no less.
Exactly. I love it. All right. Thanks, Richard, as always. And we'll see you tomorrow.
I'm beaming up. We'll see you tomorrow, Erica. See you.
There we go.